Chapter 7, Line 3. On factoid books, you must depend. Real constructive mental power lies in the creative thought that shapes your destiny, and your hour-by-hour mental conduct produces power for change in your life. Develop a train of thought on which to ride. The nobility of your life, as well as your happiness, depends on the direction in which that train of thought is going. Quote from Lawrence J. Peter, 1919 to 1988. Definition of factoid. According to Webster's New World Dictionary and Thesaurus, the word factoid means a single fact or statistic variously regarded as being trivial, useless, unsubstantiated, etc. Although many of you may feel that the multiple choice exam questions you've seen in the past, which seem to be based on minutiae, fit the literal definition of factoid. The way we're going to use the word is as an acronym. For this book, the abbreviation factoid means frequently asked concepts to own in depth. Stay with me here. Multiple choice questions are nothing more than inquiries about how much you know about a subject and how well you understand key concepts. The idea behind factoids is that you are actively learning and remembering little facts that are short and to the point so they can readily pass into and out of your brain. By breaking down complex information into shorter sentences or phrases, you're able to handle the key concepts more efficiently. By having small bits or bytes of information go in and out of your brain, you're better prepared to recall and recognize specific factoids during your timed multiple-choice exams. The Aim Your Brain study system is designed to expose you to important frequently asked concepts so that you know them and can recall them quickly and easily. If you really know a key concept, then it's yours to own. Content books give you references that you can use for review. The Aim Your Brain system makes sure that you convert your weak areas into concepts that you can store accurately in your brain's database for rapid future retrieval. How to make a factoid book. As you may recall, in the Fast Start section in Chapter 5, you were told to go to the store and buy a few items if you didn't already have them. For those of you who skipped the Fast Start and Mock Schedule sections, here's what you need to do. Buy several spiral-bound, single-subject notebooks. Do not get one of those five-subject doodads. If this sounds a little authoritarian, I apologize. At least you get to choose the color of your factoid book cover. Ditch the highlighters and use one color of ink, black or blue. Make sure there's lots of white space. One line of space between similar concepts, two lines of space between new concepts. Factoid format examples. Let's take another look at the sample questions from Chapter 2. Each of the three examples is in a multiple-choice format and contains a stem, distractors, and the correct answer. In real life, if you miss any of these questions while using your online question bank, you have an opportunity to review an explanation of the correct answer. To make the sample questions more real, I've added an explanation to each of the three examples. Please take a moment to review the three sample questions, answers, and explanation. Example 1. A 22-year-old woman has just been diagnosed with HIV. She has heard about a new class of medications called integrase inhibitors. Which of the following drugs is an integrase inhibitor? Stem. A. Lamivudine. Distractor. B. Roltegravir. Correct answer. C. Ribavirin. Distractor. D. Rifampin. Distractor. E. Ritonavir. Distractor. Explanation. There are currently six classes of antiretroviral drugs. The following table lists them individually. Multi-class combination products are listed as well. Roltegravir is the first integrase inhibitor, aka HIV integrase strand transfer inhibitor, currently available. Lamivudine, 3TC, is a nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitor, NRTI. Ribavirin is an antiviral nucleoside analog used in combination with interferon to treat hepatitis C. Rifampin is an antimicrobacterial agent commonly used to treat tuberculosis. Ritonavir, RTV, is a protease inhibitor, PI. Drugs used in the treatment of HIV infection. Multiclass combination products. Brand name: Atripla. Generic names: Efavirenz, Emtricitabine, and tenofovir disoproxil fumarate. Manufacturer name: Bristol Myers Squibb and Gilead Sciences. Approval date: 12th of July, 2006. Time to approval: 2.5 months. Nucleoside Reverse Transcriptase Inhibitors, NRTIs. Brand name, Combivir. Generic names, Lamivudine and Zidovudine. Manufacturer name, GlaxoSmithKline. Approval date, 27th of September, 1997. Time to approval, 3.9 months. Brand name, Imtriva. Generic name, Imtricitabine FTC. Manufacturer name, Gilead Sciences. Approval date, 2nd of July, 2003. Time to approval, 10 months. Brand name, Epivir. Generic name, Lamivudine 3TC. Manufacturer name, GlaxoSmithKline. Approval date, 17th of November, 1995. Time to approval, 4.4 months. Brand name, Epsicom. Generic names, Abacavir and Lamivudine. Manufacturer name, GlaxoSmithKline. Approval date, 2nd of August, 2004. Time to approval, 10 months. Brand name, Hyvid. Generic names, Zalcitabine, Dideoxycytidine, DDC. Manufacturer name, Hoffman LaRoche. Approval date, 19th of June, 1992. Time to approval, 7.6 months. Brand name, Retrovir. Generic names, Zidovudine, Azidothymidine, AZT, ZDV. Manufacturer name, GlaxoSmithKline. Approval date, 19th of March, 1987. Time to approval, 3.5 months. Brand name, Trizavir. Generic names, Abacavir, Zidovudine, and Lamivudine. Manufacturer name, GlaxoSmithKline. Approval date, 14th of November, 2000. Time to approval, 10.9 months. Brand name, Truvada. Generic names, Tenofovir disoproxil fumarate and Imtricitabine. Manufacturer name, Gilead Sciences. Approval date, 2nd of August, 2004. Time to approval, 5 months. Brand name, Videx EC. Generic name, Enteric-coated didanosine, DDI-EC. Manufacturer name, Bristol-Myers Squibb. Approval date, 31st of October, 2000. Time to approval, 9 months. Brand name, Videx. Generic names, didanosine, didioxyanosine, DDI. Manufacturer name, Bristol-Myers Squibb. Approval date, 9th of October, 1991. Time to approval, 6 months. Brand name, Viriad. Generic name, tenofovir disoproxil fumarate, TDF. Manufacturer name, Gilead. Approval date, 26th of October, 2001. Time to approval, 5.9 months. Brand name, Zeret. Generic name, Stavudine, D4T. Manufacturer name, Bristol-Myers Squibb. Approval date, 24th of June, 1994. Time to approval, 5.9 months. Brand name, Zyogen. Generic name, Abacavir Sulfate, ABC. Manufacturer name, GlaxoSmithKline. Approval date, 17th of December, 1998. Time to approval, 5.8 months. NNRTIs. Brand name, Intellence. Generic name, Intravirine. Manufacturer name, Tibotec Therapeutics. Approval date, 18th of January, 2008. Time to approval, 6 months. Brand name, Rescriptor. Generic name, Dilavudine DLV. Manufacturer name, Pfizer. Approval date, 4th of April, 1997. Time to approval, 8.7 months. Brand name, Systeva. Generic name, Efavirenz, EFV. Manufacturer name, Bristol-Myers Squibb. Approval date, 17th September, 1998. Time to approval, 3.2 months. Brand name, Virimune. Generic name, Nevirapine, NVP. Manufacturer name, Boehringer Ingelheim. Approval date, 21st of June, 1996. Time to approval, 3.9 months. Protease inhibitors, PIs. Brand name, Agenerase. Generic name, Aprenavir APV. Manufacturer name, GlaxoSmithKline. Approval date, 15th of April, 1999. Time to approval, 6 months. Brand name, Ativis. Generic name, Tipronavir, TPV. Manufacturer name, Boehringer Ingelheim. Approval date, 22nd of June, 2005. Time to approval, 6 months. Brand name, Crixivan. Generic name, Indinavir, IDV. Manufacturer name, Merck. Approval date, 13th of March, 1996. Time to approval, 1.4 months. Brand name, Fortovase. Generic name, Sequinavir, no longer marketed. Manufacturer name, Hoffmann La Roche. Approval date, 7th of November, 1997. Time to approval, 5.9 months. Brand name, Invarase. Generic name, Sequinavir Mesylate, SQV. Manufacturer name, Hoffmann La Roche. Approval date, 6th of December, 1995. Time to approval, 3.2 months. Brand name, Keletra. Generic names, Lopinavir and Ritonavir, LPV/RTV. Manufacturer name, Abbott Laboratories. Approval date, 15th of September, 2000. Time to approval, 3.5 months. Brand name, Luxeva. Generic name, Fosaprenavir Calcium, FOS-APV. Manufacturer name, GlaxoSmithKline. Approval date, 20th of October, 2003. Time to approval, 10 months. Brand name, Norvir. Generic name, Ritonavir, RTV. Manufacturer name, Abbott Laboratories. Approval date, 1st of March, 1996. Time to approval, 2.3 months. Brand name, Prezista. Generic name, Darunavir. Manufacturer name, Tibotec Inc. Approval date, 23rd of June, 2006. Time to approval, 6 months. Brand name, Reataz. Generic name, Atazanavir Sulfate, ATV. Manufacturer name, Bristol-Myers Squibb. Approval date, 20th of June, 2003. Time to approval, 6 months. Brand name, Viracept. Generic name, Nalfinavir Mesylate, NFV. Manufacturer name, Algeron Pharmaceuticals. Approval date, 14th of March, 1997. Time to approval, 2.6 months. Fusion inhibitors. Brand name, Fusion. Generic name, Infuvertide, T-20. Manufacturer name, Hoffmann La Roche and Trimeris. Approval date, 13th of March, 2003. Time to approval, 6 months. Entry inhibitors, -CCR5 co-receptor antagonist. Brand name, Selzentry. Generic name, Maraviroc. Manufacturer name, Pfizer. Approval date, 2nd of August, 2007. Time to approval, 8 months. HIV integrase strand transfer inhibitors. Brand name, Ecentris. Generic name, Raltegravir. Manufacturer name, Merck & Company Incorporated. Approval date, 12th of October, 2007. Time to approval, 6 months. At this point, it's important to make a few notes in your factoid book. See figure 7-1. That'll help you remember the information. If you missed the question, you must correct your misinformation now and jot down a few brief notes so you won't miss the question again. The notes you write can be in outline form or a single sentences. On occasion, you may end up photocopying a chart or graph you have from previous lectures or readings and pasting or taping it into your factoid book. That's fine. Just don't spend all your time putting together a scrapbook and not getting through your questions for that day. Remember to include lots of white space between your entries. Also, please don't copy the entire question, answer, and explanation word for word from your online question bank. I don't want you to break any copyright rules. The pages in your factoid book might look like the following. See figure 7-1 and 7-2. Figure 7-1, new factoid book page. 6 classes of antiretroviral (ARV) drug classes for HIV/AIDS. Nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitors, NRTIs, lamivudine. Non-nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitors, NNRTIs. Protease inhibitors, PIs, ritonavir. Entry inhibitors, CCR5 co-receptor antagonists. HIV integrase strand transfer inhibitors, raltegravir. Figure 7-2, continuation of factoid book notes on new page. Ribavirin, equal, antiviral nucleoside analog used in combination with interferon to treat hepatitis C. Rifampin, equals, antimycobacterial agent commonly used to treat tuberculosis, TB. The white space makes it easier to review your factoid book in the future. If you cram all your factoids so tightly into a few pages that you can't read them, you've wasted your time. If you don't include white space, and the factoid book pages are covered with a dense forest of ink, you won't want to use it as much. Your eyes see too much to read, and your brain thinks too much to review. Having some white space enables you to add other notes and information. Many textbooks are trying to engage the brain with white space, color, and images. Your customized factoid book will engage your brain as well. Give it a chance. Example 2. Figure 2.1. Influenza A variants. During August to October 2004, sporadic human cases of bird flu were reported in Vietnam and Thailand. The above transmission electron micrograph, TEM, shows two of the avian influenza A variants. What is the influenza A virus subtype of greatest concern for avian flu? A. H1N1. Distractor. B. H1N2. Distractor. C. H3N2. Distractor. D. H4N1. Distractor. E. H5N1. Correct answer. Explanation. There are three types of influenza viruses, A, B, and C. Only influenza A viruses are further classified by subtype on the basis of two main surface glycoproteins, hemagglutinin, HA, and neuraminidase, NA. Subtypes of influenza A that are currently circulating among people worldwide include H1N1, H1N2, and H3N2 viruses. Influenza viruses are normally highly species-specific. Since 1959, instances of human infection with an avian influenza virus have been documented on only 10 occasions. Of the hundreds of strains of avian influenza A viruses, only four are known to have caused human infections: H5N1, H7N3, H7N7, and H9N2. The H5N1 virus is highly pathogenic. Of all influenza viruses that circulate in birds, H5N1 is of greatest present concern for human health. H4N1 is not a current subtype. Take a look at Figure 7-3 and notice how it's growing. The entries are a little closer together than in Figure 7-1. This is really personal preference. The main point is spreading things out and lots of white space. Figure 7-3, factoid book page with less white space. Ribavirin, equal, antiviral nucleoside analog used in combination with interferon to treat hepatitis C. Rifampin, equal, antimycobacterial agent commonly used to treat tuberculosis, TB. Three types of influenza viruses, A, B, C. Subtype classification. Only pertains to influenza A, based on surface glycoproteins, hemagglutinin, HA, neuraminidase, NA. Four subtypes of avian influenza A cause human infections. H5N1, equal, greatest concern, highly pathogenic. H7N3, H7N7, H9N2. Other subtypes circulating in humans. H1N1, H1N2, H3N2. Please observe that I just continued writing my notes where I left off from the last entry. Don't try to organize your notes by topic. Your factoid book entries are somewhat random, and that keeps things interesting. Example 3. Figure 2.2, vaginal wet mount. The above wet mount shows what type of infection. A. Bacterial vaginosis. Distractor. B. Candida albicans. Correct answer. C. Chlamydia trachomatis. Distractor. D. E. coli. Distractor. E. Trichomonas vaginalis. Distractor. Explanation. The three diseases most frequently associated with vaginal discharge are bacterial vaginosis, BV, replacement of normal vaginal flora by an overgrowth of anaerobic microorganisms, i.e. Gardnerella vaginalis, trichomoniasis, T. vaginalis, and candidiasis, usually caused by Candida albicans. Discharge can be further examined by diluting one sample in 1 to 2 drops of 0.9% normal saline solution on one slide, and a second sample in 10% potassium hydroxide, KOH, solution. An amine odor detected immediately after applying KOH suggests BV. Cover slips are placed on the slides, and they are examined under a microscope at low and high dry power. Motile T. vaginalis, or clue cells, epithelial cells with borders obscured by small bacteria, which are characteristic of BV, usually are identified easily in the saline specimen. The yeast or pseudohyphae of Candida species are more easily identified in the KOH specimen. The slide pictured above shows a yeast infection caused by Candida albicans. E. coli and chlamydia infections are usually not diagnosed by wet mount. See Figure 7-1 for factoid book page notes. Figure 7-1, factoid book page continuation. Three most common diseases with vaginal DC: bacterial vaginosis, BV, overgrowth of anaerobes, Gardnerella vaginalis, amine odor with KOH, clue cells, trichomoniasis, T. vaginalis, motile on saline specimen.